123 1001.
Now, we've heard already about an RTE programme this evening, and here's another one, and it's a new short series that premieres tonight, and it's set in Burnfoot. Tonight's Return of the Wild, The Bear Man of Buncrana. I like that. It's a four-part series following Inis Owen man, Killian McLaughlin. We've heard from Killian many times. Of course, he and his wife, of course, courageously set up the Wild Ireland Sanctuary.
All as I wanted to do was be around animals. As a child, I remember sitting down with my mum at the kitchen table and putting down my toy animals and making a map of what I had planned out for my zoo.
It really has been his life's obsession. I think when he got his first hamster and his hobby train set up, then I think that was the start of it.
I started to rescue stray dogs, stray cats. You get a knock on the door in the middle of the night, maybe somebody with an injured animal.
Killian McLaughlin's always been an animal lover, and his family home in Buncrana has been turned into something of a mini zoo.
Every waif or stray that ever turned up in Buncrana usually ended up in my back garden.
This is an Arctic blue fox. I rescued him from a fur farm.
Part of my plan is to open a conservation centre. I think it'll inspire people to want to help.
I think it was always just understood. You know, that animals were Killian's life. The idea just evolved.
Killian, that sounds brilliant, man.
It does indeed, Mark.
Doesn't it?
Very exciting.
Yeah.
Very exciting.
You had to keep this kind of under the hat. Declan had heard the rumours, but it was Declan who first heard the rumours that you were opening up at all. It's been quite the journey, Killian. And a sense, I think, if the reading the blurb, that yourself and the family thought, oh, sure, we'll have a go at this. Did you realise at the start how much you had bitten off?
I don't think so, Mark. I think maybe if I had known the enormity of the project, I might have thought twice about maybe taking it on or embarking on the journey in the first place. But I'm so glad I did. You know, when you see now our bears have just learned to swim over lockdown, which is fabulous, you know, and you see where they've come from and see how far they've come with the work that me and my team at Wild Ireland have done with them. It's just fabulous. And then all the local people and actually national all over the country have come to Wild Ireland and learned about our native animals. So it's just, it's brilliant. It's taken off really in a way that I never expected.
I think we can proudly say, I think Declan's report was the first report of anybody, and we're proud of that.
I think he was. I think so. Yes, I remember it well when he was there the first morning.
Indeed, indeed. Killian, there's something obviously, you know, restorative about what you're doing. I was leafing through the Donegal Atlas when I was off there, and just painting a picture of how, you know, Ireland came about at all and the retreat of the glaciers. And, you know, a couple of centuries ago it reads here, Ireland was clothed in a thick blanket of temperate rainforest, inhabited by wolves, brown bears, Eurasian lynx, wild boar, and many other animals. That's not a million years ago. That's what, 300-400 years?
Absolutely. I mean, the forest really started to be cleared in this country about 2,000 years ago when we really started to farm agriculture and, believe it or not, paper making and boats. And, you know, boats were once made of timber. So the forest started to disappear, and that's when we started to lose the bears and the lynx and the bigger animals. But the forest itself kept going. There's still tiny little pockets of it left. Mark, the wolves went extinct here less than 300 years ago. People don't realise that Ireland is considered part of the temperate rainforest belt. The forest is gone, but we still have the rain. When you look at the rain in the context of a forest, a rainforest, in fact, it all makes sense. You know, one of the characteristics of a rainforest, both tropical and temperate, is where you get plants growing on other plants. And that we see that and take it for granted here in Ireland when we see moss, lichens, ferns, algae growing on our trees. That only happens in the rainforest, and it happens in Ireland. It happens in the tropics, in Brazil and places like that. You know, it really is an incredible habitat. It's the rarest habitat in the world. The biggest temperate rainforest in the world is on the west coast of Canada. But Ireland's there, you know, and just a little bit of the western part of the UK and Scotland would be considered temperate rainforest.
You see, you and I talked about this before, and you think, right, we're doing the big park here and there is so much room in it, but you feel that those, you know, those kinds of scenarios can't be revisited. I'm just looking at the World Wildlife Fund. They're saying that wildlife populations have shrunk by 2/3 since 1970. But when I tell you, Killian, when I see young people coming through, like Dara McAnulty, he says, welcome on Twitter, the young writer, to the Anthropocene. Nature is not separate from us. We are just the major species wreaking havoc. So much so, he tweets, that it will be irreparable. However, Killian, when you see the passion of the army of young people, it seems to me, across the world. This notion of restoration might not be as far away as maybe our generation might sort of fear it is.
I hope so, Mark, and I hope what I've done at Wild Ireland and creating this documentary will start this conversation. It's a conversation that everybody's been avoiding because development equals big cash for those in power, you know, and maybe this is a conversation now that will start. And God knows, maybe my son or my grandchildren might be witness to a rewilding of Ireland, which humans and nature are not two separate things. We are a part of nature. And without that, you know, we won't survive and nature won't survive. We really need to point a big finger at ourselves. We often watch wildlife documentaries and say how terrible it is what people are doing in other parts of the world, hunting their animals and poaching and elephants and tigers being traded on the black market, ivory and whatnot. But like, there's a big finger pointing back at us. You know, you guys have eradicated your big predators, your bears, your wolves, yeah, your lynx. We eradicated our golden eagles. The Golden Eagle Trust brought them back in the early 2000s. We are now in danger of losing them for a second time. They're about to go extinct here for a second time if we don't cop on and stop shooting them and poisoning them. That's very embarrassing on our nation that, you know, that we're going to let an animal go extinct for a second time.
Incredible.
So I hope this documentary, and I hope Wild Ireland gets that message across, that it's in our hands.
Here, by the way, you breezed past the latest potential young campaigner there. Yourself and Katie have brought young Regan into the world.
Yes.
A certain, yeah. So you don't have a whole pile of time in your hands, do you?
No, Mark, I never even get a chance to breathe, never mind anything else. But yeah, Regan is 12 weeks old on Sunday.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Yeah, so he's going to have an interesting childhood growing up in the forest with bears and wolves, of all things.
Well, you see, that's the thing, and invariably the kids in that kind of, with that kind of exposure, I'm thinking about your man Steve, who was sadly killed, of course, in Australia, yeah, you know, bringing his kids up cheek by jowl with stuff. It's you know, it can change a child's life, obviously.
Absolutely. Mark, every child is born with a curiosity and a fascination with the natural world. It's as we grow older that we lose that, and it should be nurtured. It should be nurtured by our parents, by our schools. I don't know why I wasn't taught in school about bears and wolves and temperate rainforests in Ireland. That didn't come into the curriculum. That has to be nurtured. And if we're going to be serious about conservation in the future, we need to start that conversation now with kids when they're in school and they're learning. This should be part of their education. It would have been a big part of our education for our ancestors. I mean, I often stand in a forest with a group that I might be giving a talk to, and the wolves will start howling, the bears might be growling in the background, and I point out to them, these are the sounds, the smells and the sights that our ancestors would have been so familiar with. We've forgotten about it.
Killian, you're an inspiration. You know, I'm sure a lot of listeners are thinking the very same thing, and you do it in such a, you know, very matter of fact kind of a way. And an old friend of your family was saying, even when you were a wee nipper, you were the boy out in Buncrana, you know, rescuing the wee sparrow that had fallen, or, you know, it was just, yeah, in you. You know, just is that born in you, or where do you think that came from?
I've no idea. As long as I can remember, Mark, it's been just animals. Fascinated by them, and I never lost that, and I was very lucky that my family encouraged me and nurtured that. As I said earlier, I think that all kids should, that passion or that curiosity should be nurtured, definitely, and if everybody started to think just a little bit differently, we might have an opportunity to save the little pockets of forest that we have left. You know, we've red squirrels, we've pine martens, we've beautiful wildlife that people aren't even aware of in their back garden, and you know, they will go the way of the wolf and the way of the bear if we don't preserve them now.
Killian, I wish you well with it. A lot of people, we're only so happy today to shine a light on our public service competitor, RTE. It's half past eight tonight on RTE1, so you're going to get a heck of an audience there.
It's a fascinating documentary. It's been fly on the wall, literally. I've got so used to them sticking the camera in my face that I forgot they were there.
But that's the best way. That's the best.
Exactly. Thing. And the guys have become part of the family, the director, Shane Brennan, and the cameraman, Pascal. They became part of the family. You know, they were there all the time. Okay. They were there for all the big events. They were at our wedding. So it's a character-driven. It focuses on my journey and Katie's journey and obviously young Regan coming into the world. So it really is a fascinating watch.
Brilliant. Brilliant. We wish you well with it. Killian, we'll talk again. Only too happy to. Killian McLaughlin there, the founder of Wild Ireland in Burnfoot. And that's tonight, Return of the Wild, the Bear Man of Buncrana, the first of four programmes. Opens tonight, RTE 1, 8:30. Just before I move on to the important issue of mental well-being, just another unbelievable day for local teenager Dara McInulty. Yesterday we were talking about how he had won the Wainwright Prize, the